Hello, welcome back. So in this part, we will understand another concept, which is cracked and uncracked section. Well, we use these two terms in our design, and we will try to understand what is the meaning of cracked and uncracked section in case of concrete design. Well, concrete in the extreme fiber, in case of tension, concrete in the extreme fiber of a beam section is expected to crack in flexure for the first time when stress reaches the value of modulus of rupture. Well, this is a very important statement, and we need to understand what it means. Well, what we do in our design, we expect that concrete will have some crack, and when this crack will appear, what will happen? The concrete, I mean, now try to understand in relation to this section. What is happening? When the load first time comes on this beam, what will happen? First, the whole concrete beam will take all load, both compression as well as tension. As I said earlier also, practically, until the, I mean, below the neutral axis, we consider that concrete is cracked. But initially, when we are using the concrete, when we are making the beam of concrete, I mean concrete beam, then initially what will happen? When the load will try to bend it, concrete also have some tensile strength, and concrete also has compressive strength. So initially, concrete alone will take that bending effect. When the concrete in the tension region will crack, then only concrete will transfer that tension stress to the steel. So to transfer stress on the steel, concrete is expected to crack. So now the bending strength of concrete sometimes is expressed in this term, modulus of rupture. So this modulus of rupture is actually the measure of bending strength of the beam. And bending strength of beam is expressed as cracking moment. So the moment at which first crack will occur, that moment will be known as cracking moment. So cracking moment is expressed by this formula. Now we will try to understand how this formula is arrived. Well, in the bending equation, in the elastic theory, in the bending equation, we know that bending equation is M by I, F by Y, and E by R. So if we take these two terms, so with these two terms, this formula has arrived. M, if we say M as MCR, which is the cracking moment, the moment required for the first crack in the concrete, so which is called MCR. So MCR is equals to F multiplied by I upon Y. So now this F is the modulus of rupture, which I am saying FCR. And similarly, this I is the moment of inertia of the transformed section. So this becomes IT. And Y is the distance from neutral axis to the point where we need to find out the MCR value, or where we have to find out the cracking moment capacity in the section. So generally this Y is the, this Y also called T. YT is the T I'm saying here for the transformed section. So now you understand what is Y. Y is the distance from neutral axis to the point where we need to find out the cracking capacity. So generally maximum, I mean the extreme fiber at this point, extreme fiber, topmost and lowermost, these points are maximum stressed, and because of that, sometimes we take the value of YT as this value, say this one, D by 2. So we call it D by 2. Similarly, if we try to find out MCR at the reinforcement level, that also is D by 2. Okay, so this is how this value is arrived. So we want to find out what will be the cracking capacity of the concrete? Now, how do we find out this FCR value? Well, this FCR value formula is directly given in the IS code, which is 0.7 times of under root FCK. So if we have all the sections, all the values, we can find out the cracking moment capacity. Now we will try to understand this in the using the diagram. So now in this diagram, what is happening? Well, this part is the actual section, and this part is transformed section. So now we understood how do we transform the section into this transformed section from the actual section. So I have explained that in the previous part. So now we will go further. So now first we need to understand, in the previous slide I told you how do we find out MCR. So MCR is the capacity of beam in bending before the first crack. I mean, before getting first crack in the concrete, the bending which this beam is able to take will be called as cracking moment. So when we apply moment less than, I mean, when the moment applied in this beam will be less than M. Sorry. When the moment apply in this beam will be less than MCR, what will happen? This is the actual moment, which is because of the load. So if it is less than the value of MCR, what will happen? The stress in the concrete will be there, but steel will not be contributing. And when M is greater than MCR, at least for first time, then what will happen? The concrete will crack in below the tension region. Concrete will crack, and it further transfer the stress to the steel. So this will happen when the value of M will be more than MCR. So that is the concept of cracked section. So now in this diagram, this is the condition when there is a uncracked phase, which means M is less than MCR. So in this phase, what is happening? Now you can see in the transform section, you can see I have hatched all the part. So in this whole beam is hatched, which is displaying that the whole beam, the whole concrete is taking bend, compression as well as tension. When this condition is there, which means when the moment is less than MCR, at that time concrete is taking tension as well as the compression. But as the value of M is more than MCR, what will happen? Then concrete will be taking compression above the neutral axis, and below the neutral axis steel will be taking the tension. So this is the diagram that we are trying to understand, which is the uncracked phase. In the next slide I will be showing you the phase when there will be cracked phase. So in the uncracked phase, you can see this this part I am showing you. This part is the equivalent area of the concrete in terms of, equivalent area in terms of concrete. So here we know that there are steel. What we have done, we have replaced this steel with the equivalent area of the concrete. So this extra, this excessive area is showing that. And as before the crack, steel is present, because steel is not contributing, so steel is present. So the area will be equivalent area minus the area of steel, actual steel. So this is how it is being calculated. So this is basically AST into M minus the AST. So this is the case which is there. which means in uncracked face, steel is already there, but it is not taking the tension. And because of that, this equivalent area is also inactive. So only this part is taking the bending effect in terms of compression, in terms of tension. Once the section is cracked, concrete will be taking compression, and the equivalent area or the steel will be taking the tension. So we will see that in the next diagram. So now this is the case when cracking will be there in the cracked phase. In the previous part, one thing I want to show you. Well, there it is written, complete section is effective in, it is not resting, it is actually the resisting. In resisting the tension. So now, here we see, this is the uncracked face. And this is the cracked face. So in the uncracked face, this will be when M value is less than MCR. And this will occur when M value is greater than MCR. So now you can see here, whole concrete is taking the tension and compression. But when the value of M is more than MCR, what will happen? The concrete will be cracked below. So there you can see here, the whole concrete is taking the tension and compression, but when the M value will be greater than MCR, then the stress in the steel will be transferred. And this stress will be a little higher. Why? Because of this higher stress, the concrete is cracking. So that higher stress will have to be balanced. And because of that, the neutral axis will be shifting upward. So this is the common phenomena that occur when there is a transformation of uncracked to cracked section. So that is the concept that I wanted to share with you. I hope you understand the concept. So in this, you can see the variation. Now you can see after cracking, the hatch portion is left up to the NA part. So above NA, it is taking the compression. And below the NA, only this part is active, which is taking the tension. All other part is cracked and is not taking the tension. While in this case, you can see below the neutral axis also, it is hatched part. Why? Because this is the this is the uncracked phase. So I hope you understand the concept. So we will continue our discussion in the next part.